and welcome to a web-only edition of Big 12 Sports Saturday with 540 ESPN. I'm Dan Needles. He's Drew Olsen. Major upset at the U.S. Open, and people didn't see this coming. Serena Williams losing in the semifinals when everyone was ready to crown her for having the first one-year Grand Slam since Steffi Graf in 1988. And the woman who beat her ended up losing in the U.S. Open final, and her name will be lost in history. I can't even remember it already.
I can't remember it right now.
So that made me think, Drew, in our lifetimes, and combined we've lived, what, 130, 140 years?
Something like that. We've been covering sports that long in the area, yes.
We've seen a lot of upsets. Now, I would always want to pick the Jets and Joe Namath beating the Colts in the Super Bowl, but I was so young, I didn't witness it. So we're going with things that saw with our own eyes.
We've seen.
How would you rank them?
Well, first of all, let me just say that Serena is still the athlete of the year, even though it's like she failed. She didn't win. She dominated.
No.
She's still the athlete of the year.
She's not the athlete of the year.
She's still the athlete.
You know who's going to get the athlete of the year?
Who?
A horse.
A horse?
That won the triple crown.
Athlete of the year. It begins and ends for us, if you're of our vintage, with the 1980 Miracle on Ice, the U.S. hockey team beating Russia. That was the game. That's the upset of our. We'll never see one that tops that, I don't think.
I agree with that. I have that as number one also. Number two, Buster Douglas over Mike Tyson.
Ooh, good one.
I don't think we'll ever see it.
It was in Japan.
Right. I don't think we'll see a number one, a heavyweight or any boxer who captures the imagination of the world the way Mike Tyson did, good and bad. He was talked about. Everybody knew who he was. Nobody knows who the heavyweight champion is now, but he was invincible. A guy named Buster Douglas, who was a huge underdog, knocks him out, and the invincibility was gone. I don't think we'll see that in boxing ever again.
Buster didn't parlay that into a lot.
No, he didn't. Who's your number two?
All right, since you have that one, I'll go with one from our childhood when Ralph Sampson was the king of college basketball. He was a big University of Virginia fan, and they lost in Hawaii to Chaminade.
Oh, I forgot about that
Chaminade beat, and Chaminade, no one had ever heard of it. What is it? Chaminade. It sounds like a champagne or something, like some kind of drink or a cocktail. Chaminade. I'll have a Chaminade, Dan. No, it's Chaminade beat Ralph Sampson. They were supposed to be indomitable. They were supposed to be invincible. Ralph Sampson was supposed to be the greatest player ever going from college into the pros, and that never really materialized either.
No,
I don't know if it's because of Chaminade, but it was an unbelievable, like, the tectonic plates of college basketball shifted with that game.
He never won a national championship, and he was never what he was supposed to be in the pros, but he is in the Hall of Fame. My number three, North Carolina State, speaking of the ACC, beating Houston in Jim Valvano's big moment in the NCAA championship game. And it's kind of tied with Villanova-Georgetown, which was the following year in the NCAA, or two years later, in the NCAA championship game. Nowadays, if somebody wins in a big upset, it would have to be, say, a few years ago when Butler was in the championship game. If they had beaten Duke, that might have been at this level.
They were a ranked team, though. They were still a ranked team.
Well,
they were.
I mean, Villanova, North Carolina State, neither one was ranked. They were thought well of, but you need to understand history to understand the gravity of this. Georgetown was a team that was going to be crowned one of the greatest of all time. They had won it the year before, and they lose to Villanova, a team they had crushed three times earlier. And North Carolina State beating Houston, by slam-a-jamma, one of the greatest basketball teams of all time in college basketball.
I still,
You know,
that one stands
out. Shocking. These are all shocking.
Well, as long as we're at the start of the football season here, we might as well just say that one of mine would be Appalachian State beating Michigan in the Big House to open the season. Again, I don't think has a double-A school beaten a Division
One. I don't think
power.
They have
I
since
don't
then.
I think that might be it. And that was, again, that was a sign. Everybody's on TV all the time now, and it's college football is. You know, the distance between Appalachian State and Alabama isn't what it used to be. We'll put it that way. I mean, the landscape has changed largely because of television, but those teams are closer together now, and that's what we're seeing. We're seeing upsets. We saw the SEC lose a couple games, or almost lose Auburn, almost losing Arkansas, losing, you know.
Holy Toledo, Brett Bielema. My favorite college football upset of my lifetime, Miami beating Nebraska in the Orange Bowl in 84 when Nebraska seemed invincible. Heisman Trophy winner Mike Rozier, Turner Gill, Irving Fryer. They put up 84 points, I think, on Minnesota during the year. And Miami and Bernie Kosar beat them for their first national championship.
How about locally, though? Not to beat up on Michigan, but I remember the Badgers beating Michigan to open the season at Camp Randall when Michigan was ranked number one in the country, right? And that was at a time when the Badgers, they had nothing going. They had, you know, they didn't have a lot.
Mine would, you got a couple of times that Wisconsin has beaten Ohio State, and I think the Buckeyes were number one both times. I do remember with Jim, or it wasn't Jim Sorge, he got knocked out of the game. Who is the guy that came in and replaced him? Lost in the lore of my mind, they threw a touchdown pass to Lee Evans in the final minute and beat the Buckeyes, ended a long losing streak, and a couple of years ago they beat him again, too. But I think that Michigan game is the one that's going to stand out. Preseason number one in the country, Michigan. Wisconsin hadn't done anything, and they finally got to a bowl game that year. It was kind of the start of modern Wisconsin football.
It really was.
Those are some of our favorite upsets. We'll try not to upset you. Make sure you join us every Saturday at 6:30, Big 12 Sports Saturday, with 540 ESPN.